Just as you're about to address the lizard, the Red Prince bars you with an outstretched arm.
This man is a dreamer. As you know, I need a word with him. You may wait here while I speak. Permission indeed.
He bids the dreamer stand up and pay attention, which he does in a groveling and awkward manner. The dreamer then chews and swallows a handful of Drudenay leaves before slipping into a trance-like state. He falls asleep. To your surprise, the Red Prince lies down and follows suit. After about half an hour, they wake up and begin to discuss what they saw in their dreams. The Red Prince pinches the bridge of his nose in apparent irritation before turning his back on the jabbering dreamer. You receive a withering glance in response.
A deserved bit of sarcasm, I suppose. But though this sting-tailed fellow may be a less than stellar specimen in the firmament of dreamers, the dreams themselves prove to be quite elucidating. Turns out I'm being hunted by an enemy I didn't know actually existed. The myth-shrouded House of Shadows. The dreamers, though, they're on my side. And they've visions of me on the throne. Of course it is. I was born with the promise of an empire, and that promise will be kept. But to keep it, I must find a second dreamer. A greater one. A more experienced traveler of the dream world. Bahara is her name, and she resides in the swamplands east of the fort. So, let us make our escape and venture there post-haste.
I could tell you all about swamp dreamers too if I chewed that much Drudenay.
Oh, do hold your prickly tongue.
Huh? What? But I was... It was... Please, tell me. Tell me. Why did you wake me? I was so close. So close. And you smell of burnt hair and barren dreams. But I have the good breeding not to mention it. Supplies? You mean the oranges, I suppose. Though I'd guess Mr. Griff is more upset about the Drudenay than the citrus. The Drudenay Griff cleverly smuggles into the prison, of course, stuffed inside the oranges. You don't think he'd really be so mad over a little missing fruit, do you? No, it's not the oranges, but the dreams he's after. Same as I, though. I have the right, the responsibility. Drudenay, it makes you master of all you see when you sleep. The dreamer is not the play actor, but the playwright. It may be hard for you to understand, but my kind... We dream for the greater good. What we see can predict the truth, can even shape the truth. But we need Drudenay to do it. Before I was caught, before I was brought here, I saw a vision. The void woken, slain, divinity restored. But just as I was about to see how it happened, the Magisters beat down my door. This is my last chance. To find out the secret, to find out how to save us all. So you see, I cannot give back the Drudenay, not only for myself, but for all of us. My dreams are my gift. They may be our salvation, too. And it won't be long before he'll have it, with all his thugs lurking about. They'd stick me in my sleep if they knew. Fine, fine, take the Drudene. I'll find more. Another way. Somehow, I have to. For all our sakes. Don't mention my name to you. Please.
Griff glances from his blade to you and back again.
You there! What the devil are you doing without your collar? No harm! I've heard that before. Right before a sorcerer blasted an hole through my partner. So, you'd rather die here and now than be cured, would you? Fine by me.
Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves did meet so much. Worse than war rations, these. Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much. For beasts.
Ooh.
ain't fit for beasts. Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much. Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much. Worse than war rations, these. If those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much.
Griff glances from his blade to you and back again.
Spare the indignation and hand it over. Now. I ain't gonna ask again. Hand it over. Oh. You must think I'm playing with you. I don't play, and I'm over.
yield to none.